of her next door neighbor who, while vacuuming her floors, decided to clean out the bottom of her pet parakeet Chippy's cage. Her phone rang, and without turning off the machine, she turned around to answer it, and you guessed it. Poor Chippy got sucked through the tube and into the canister. She dropped her phone, shut off the vacuum cleaner, and opened up the canister. Well, there was Chippy, feathers askew, dirt all over his little body, stunned but alive. She rushed into the bathroom, bird in hand, and helped poor Chippy under the faucet. She turned the water on full blast, then she spotted the hairdryer, and she turned it on hot and high. The blast did the trick, but it nearly finished off poor Chippy. He just sat there and stared. I have a feeling that many of you can relate to Chippy. You've had your cage vacuumed. You felt sucked into the dirt bag, stuck under the faucet, and hit with a blast from a blower. And you don't sing much anymore. There are a lot of Chippy-style circumstances that can steal our songs. Life can suck us all into the tube. People pour cold water on our dreams. Disappointment and disaster blow us away. Many people believe in Murphy's Law. What can go wrong will go wrong. Somewhere in the drama of things like Chippy, many people lose their song. They just sort of sit there and stare. Some people are croakers, some are whiners, and some are complainers. Someone said, don't tell other people your problems because 80% don't care and the other 20% are just glad it's not them. I don't know about that, but I do know that we can all choose our attitudes. Our world is full of cage vacuumers, hair blowers, and song stealers. It's nice to know you don't have to just sit there and stare. You can open your mouth and sing this song by L.B. Bridges at the top of your voice. I wish I could sing. Jesus, 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 sweetest name I know, fills my every longing and keeps me singing as I go.
Amen.
Merry Christmas.